Aloha and welcome to another Active Tour travel adventure. Today we are in Oahu. We're gonna check out all the best things on the island. Let's get going. Oahu is an island that I visited over a dozen times, and during those trips, I did learn to love the people, the land, the culture, and to this day, still call some of the residents Ohana. A lot of people look down on Oahu because it's so busy, but if you're looking for a little solitude, you can find it. They say that the only good thing about leaving Hawaii is that you really only appreciate it when you return. Number 1, a road trip to the North Shore. Now get out of the hustle and bustle of Waikiki and explore the North Shore. Some of my favorite stretches of beach are along this road of the North Shore. In the winter you have epic surf locations like Pipeline, Waimea, Sunset Beach, and in the summer some of these locations make for great snorkeling spots as well. You definitely have to hit a shrimp truck or three like we did along the way. We'll chat about food a little bit later in this video. Now this is an all-day journey, so don't sleep in too late on your road trip around Oahu. I recommend doing the drive counterclockwise, that way you're the closest you can be to the water, and get someone else to drive too. There's a number of swimming pools, beaches, and hikes along the road that deserve its own spot on this list, so more to come on that later. Number 2, the Olamana Trail or Three Peaks. Now if you're a subscriber, you've probably already seen all of my videos from Maui, the Big Island, and the other Hawaiian islands. Now of all those hikes, I think this is the most adventurous hike I've done so far. Now if you're sure-footed and you're not afraid of heights and want spectacular views, this is it. The Olamana Trail is the most epic ridgeline scramble you'll ever do. It's quite literally along a ridgeline of a razor blade, not to mention that you'll hike up quite a bit of elevation just to get started. You are hands and feet climbing this trail just to get to the first peak, and that's the first of three. Most people stop here at the first peak, and if you're even questioning being comfortable going to the other two, you should probably play it safe and stop here. Also, the best views are at this peak. It's also the tallest of the three, so it's okay to stop. If you're intent on going to the other two and it's not rainy, be prepared to climb some ropes and do a full day of solo scrambling and climbing. This is not easy at all. My friend Eunice and I are strong hikers, and it still took us almost 6 hours to do the full trail. It was amazing to make it to the last peak, and on the way back, a number of people asked us if we were the ones hiking all the way to the third peak. Number 3, Lanaka'i Beach. Now, there's nothing quite like a perfect white sand beach, and on the windward side of the island is my favorite beach on Oahu. Lanaka'i Beach access is between multi-million dollar homes, and it's for good reason. I mean, laying out and relaxing on the soft sand here at this beach is really paradise. I recommend getting here early to get a parking spot and also catch the rays before the trade winds blow in some of the rainy clouds. If it's already raining on this side of the island, hit up the beaches on the leeward side of the island, like Kaimana Beach and Alamona Beach. Both of them are great for sunset as well. There's no better place in the world for you to try surfing for the first time, and actually hang 10 on the same day. The first surfing references were found in Polynesia, cave paintings from the 12th century showing people riding on waves. They brought it to Hawaii, and the Hawaiian people perfected the sport. Honolulu was the birthplace of Duke, the legendary surfer and competitive swimmer. Now, when you paddle out for the first time, you'll probably be just shy of Duke-like perfection, but these gentle rolling waves here last for a really long time, and you know, they just do the work for you, so don't fight it. There's a few places to rent boards right here on the beach, but to save about a two-thirds, maybe half, go in a block or two and find some lower priced surf shops. One great way to support my channel is just to hit that like button. So if you're enjoying this video, give it a thumbs up. Number 5, the Kuli'o'o Ridge Trail. Now, if you've been following my advice on the Hawaiian Islands, you'll be doing a lot of elevation gain along ridgeline hikes. Now, Oahu is the most densely populated island of the Hawaiian Islands and also has the most ridgeline hike trails that are well marked and safe. This one is a fantastic hike that takes you up into the clouds, and you can get a peek of both the windward and leeward sides of the island. The trail is 4 miles long, 1,624 feet of elevation gain along the way as well. It's also really easy to get to if you're staying in Waikiki. Now, on this particular hike, we brought some Zippies as a summit snack, so definitely do that for sure. I also recommend leaving early because the trade winds bring rain and clouds, and it's better to be there without that. The trail was also the muddiest of all the trails I hiked on all of the Hawaiian Islands so far. Hawaiian food is one of those things that I crave all the time. Floating thousands of miles between Japan and the United States are the Hawaiian Islands, with its wonderful melting pot of cuisine. You can get really amazing dim sum in Chinatown, fantastic Japanese food in Waikiki, of course amazing seafood, and a variety of different local foods here on the island. One of my all-time favorite desserts anywhere in the world is the Waiola Shave Ice Stand. But be sure to order it with ice cream and mochi. It's amazing. One of the local foods that I want to talk about here is poi. Poi is made from taro root that has been mashed and turned into a paste or a thick sauce-like consistency. It was told that the spirit of Haloa, a legendary ancestor of the Hawaiian people, was present when a bowl of poi was uncovered for consumption at the dinner table. Accordingly, all conflict amongst family members was required to come to an immediate halt. Now I just wish I could carry some poi around and stop those family arguments at the dinner table. I'm constantly finding new and exciting places to eat when I travel to Oahu, but I have a few favorites that I'll make a video of soon, so be sure to subscribe and ring that bell to get notified when that video comes out. Number 7, take a boat ride. Now, the Hawaiian people are sea voyaging explorers, and it's in the very soul of who they are. You wouldn't do the island or the people justice if you just sat on the beach drinking a Mai Tai. Fortunately, there's tons of boats out there all over Oahu that will take you exploring on the open seas with your Mai Tai. I personally love to sail, so I always opt for seeing the island on a sailboat, but if it's whale watching season in the winter, you'll absolutely want to go whale watching. There's nothing more magical than seeing one of these huge creatures breach the water. The sunset cruises are fantastic, and if you can time it with the fireworks show on Friday nights, even better. Number 8, hike Diamond Head. Now, Diamond Head is an iconic landmark in Waikiki and Oahu. You've constantly seen it in all kinds of movies and TV shows. If you've done any research on Oahu, you definitely recognize that silhouette in the background. You know, Diamond Head is a volcanic tough cone known to the Hawaiians as Leahi. The Hawaiian name is most likely derived from ahi because of the shape of the ridgeline resembles the shape of a tuna's dorsal fin. Diamond Head was closed due to COVID while I was there, but I have hiked a few times to the top of Diamond Head. The views of Waikiki are amazing. I recommend to everyone to do it on their first trip to Oahu. Back on the North Shore is Shark's Cove. Now, this is a huge tide pool aquarium that you can walk around and snorkel around in. It's usually where I spend the last daylight moments while doing a road trip around to the North Shore. It's a perfect spot for sunset on this road. Even in the winter months, you can normally snorkel in these waters protected by its cove. Hanauma Bay is a marine embayment formed within the tuff ring, and it's located along the south coast of Oahu. It's one of Oahu's most popular destinations, and for good reason. The tropical fish and coral in Hawaii is spectacular. However, due to the people not using reef-safe sunscreen and touching coral, some of our most prized places to visit have become more and more damaged. You are required to watch a video to educate yourself on protecting the reef before you enter the lands. Number 11, Tantalus Lookout. Now, if you're looking for the most amazing backdrop of Honolulu and Waikiki, you'll want to come up here for sunset. It's an almost fake looking view of the city and Diamond Head. What I like to do is come up here an hour or two early with your friends and picnic on the grass. It's a fantastic way to slow down and soak in the views. Now, I've never seen a green flash at sunset before, but I keep trying to see it. Probably doesn't help that I'm a little colorblind. Comment below if you have or know how to see it. Number 12, the Crouching Lion hike. Now this hike is a little out of bounds as there have been a number of falls on this area. So be really, really careful about where you step. And if it's raining, just don't even go there at all. We were there and it was a super dry day. It's an extremely well-trafficked hike. And so there's tons of people, even though it's not really a legal hike per se. We still went ahead with the hike. There was a ton of people there. It has one of the best views of the whole entire road trip around the north shore of Maui. It's definitely worth a stop to do this hike. Just be really careful with your footing. Number 13, the Lulumahu Falls. There's something special about a tropical waterfall that just makes me smile. It's a little harder to find here in Oahu than on the road to Hana or in Kauai, but there is one easy hike through a bamboo forest and through a few stream crossings that I just love. I've done this hike a few times, and take it from me, go early before the waterfall gets crowded later in the day. The one downside for this waterfall is that it doesn't have a swimming hole. It's fun all the same to get a great photo op. This trail does require a permit to get to the watershed area. A lot of people go without a permit though. Just do that at your own risk. Number 14, Pearl Harbor. Now the attack on Pearl Harbor was a surprise military strike by the Imperial Japanese Navy Air upon the naval base at Pearl Harbor. During this time, Hawaii was not a U.S. state, and it was only after this devastating attack that statehood grew in popularity due to the strategic placement of Hawaii in the Pacific. Here, you can take a boat out to the USS Arizona and still to this day see the oil seeping out of that ship. It's a horrific reminder of the devastations of war, and even paradise has its hardships and sadnesses. Number 15, the Lanikai Pillbox Hike. Now this trail is a 1.8 mile heavily trafficked out and back trail featuring two military bunkers and a panoramic view of Lanikai Beach. It's another grim reminder that the islands were used as a military staging points in times of war. I love hitting this hike in the morning and then spending the afternoon lounging at Lanikai Beach. This trail does get steep at times, but it's nothing compared to some of the other ridgeline hikes on this list. Number 16 is Cocohead Crater, and so this was actually the very first thing we did when we arrived here on this trip on Oahu. It was actually pretty funny because my friend Eunice, who came with me on this part of the journey, was taking a nap as we drove to the trailhead, and then we woke up. I immediately made her do all these steps to the top of Cocohead. So sorry about that, but if you're coming with me, you're probably going to do a lot of adventuring. Up here, you get lots of really great views. You can see Diamond Head and lots of East and West Maui. It's also really great for sunset, so I recommend you do that. Number 17, the Makapu'u Lighthouse Trail. This is a really great trail. It's all completely paved and really easy to walk up. There is some elevation gain from the parking lot to the lighthouse point, but it's a pretty easy hike. It is in direct sunlight the entire time, so be sure to wear a hat as well if you're worried about sun protection. It's also a really great place to stop and spot some whales. Number 18, the Byodo-in Temple. It's a non-denominational Buddhist temple located on the Valley of the Temples Memorial Park. It was dedicated in August 1968 to commemorate the 100th anniversary of the first Japanese immigrants to move to Hawaii. Okay guys, that was my list of the top things to do on Oahu. I know I probably missed a couple of people's favorites, so leave a comment below. Let me know what I missed on this list, and I'll update it in the future. Also, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. My name's Josh from Active Tours. Thanks so much for joining me on this trip.